So you've over-egged the pudding there, Vernon.
Me?
You've over-egged the pudding. A bit of Bristol boasting. I'm not sure whether we're going to take that this morning.
I'm not sure about that. We've got a special guest in the studio
as well,
who I'll introduce you to in just a couple of moments.
Special guest.
Showing off.
Come on, what have you got, Bristol?
Here we go. Here's what we've got. We've got the home of Nipper the dog, the HMV dog. You know that. We've got a suspension bridge. But we can do so much better than that because we've got 2 7 crossings. We are the home of Banksy. Do you hear that, Burnsy? We're the home of Banksy.
Graffiti. Just graffiti, not proper art. Nah,
yeah, but what about engineering? Isambard Kingdom Brunel.
Oh, yeah, he's not bad.
I could mention one of the finest actors and movie stars of the 20th century, Cary Grant. Came from right here.
Oh, yeah, good that.
The SS Great Britain, the brilliant floating harbour. Do you know, we broke the sound barrier because Bristol was the home of supersonic flight and Concorde.
We're Gobby and Grimsby.
Well, you can say that again. And I know that on Christmas afternoon, you like a little sip of your Harvey's Bristol cream, so that's because of us.
Oh, yeah.
I mentioned Shaun the Sheep. I can mention Wallace and Gromit. I can mention Bristol engines. I bet the buses and some of the commercial trucks all around Grimsby have Bristol engines in them.
Is that why they're not running on time?
Oh. Now that's fighting talk. You said you were going to be polite.
Oh, well, I lied. I lied, Vernon.
We've set our stall out.
Right, okay.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
I'll give you a countdown. 3, 2, 1.
Well, obviously, it's fish. We are Europe's food town, Vernon. Did you know that?
I can smell it from here.
The fish finger capital of Great Britain. Here's one you'll not be able to reply to. The elephant man went to Grimsby Art College.
Actually, I can't beat that.
You can't beat that, Bristol.
That is very good.
Elton John wrote a song called Grimsby.
He didn't. That's a lie. Mm-hmm. You're making it up now. Are you there? Has he fallen off the end? I think Burns is just sort of consumed in flames. He has. He's given up. He's given up the ghost already. The good news is, whilst he scrabbles around on the floor, I think the BBC Grimsby studio has probably fallen sideways. Our special guest, extolling the virtues of the West Country, is the brilliant Josie Gibson. Hello.
Hello.
Thank you so much for joining us on the programme today.
Oh, no, thank you.
Big Brother. Now, the thing, this is 2010, so 5 years ago you were in the Big Brother house.
Yeah.
It probably stays with you, doesn't it,
every single
night.
I feel old, you say that, 5 years ago.
But get this, 77.5% of the public vote when you were in Big Brother. That's amazing.
Because I'm from Bristol, you see.
That's what it is.
That's what it is. People love a Bristolian.
I do have some good news. Well, it could be good news, it could be bad news. We've managed to wind up the elastic band and the Grimsby studio is back on air.
Are you back?
No, we didn't go anywhere.
I thought when I threw in the elephant man went to Grimsby Art College, you just bottled it, thought, we're not going to beat that.
Can't compete with that.
We're not going to beat that
in
Bristol.
I'm a fair man.
Yes.
Are you probably wondering who the disembodied voice belonged to?
Yes.
Only the person who polled the biggest public vote in Big Brother, Josie Gibson, from Bristol.
How are you doing in Grimsby?
Oh, we're fine, Josie.
Not as good as us in Bristol.
Well, I don't know about that.
We're fair here, aren't we, Josie? We are fair.
We are.
So we're going to give you your minute again.
All right, okay. And I'll do it in a different order, perhaps.
If you could put another 10p in the meter, that would be brilliant.
I don't know what went on there. But I will start with fish. The best fish and chips in the world come from Grimsby. Did you know that Grimsby Town have the oldest main stand in non-league football?
They've got a new one, then.
On Sunday, Vernon, they'll have the oldest main stand in the Football League.
You think?
Yeah.
Platinum
selling number one singer Ella Henderson is from Grimsby. Most of the cars imported into the United Kingdom come into Grimsby. half a million a year, Vernon. Do you want a new motor, Vernon?
I think we could compete with Avonmouth for that
one.
Well, anyway.
I'm not sure you can. Henry Kissinger is a Grimsby Town fan. Did you know that?
That's made up as well.
It's not. Grimsby has the largest concentration of cold storage facilities in Europe. Did you know that, Vernon?
It's almost as glamorous as I thought it was going to be.
And you know the phrase, ooh, Betty, from Some Mothers Do Have Them?
Mm-hmm.
Betty is from Grimsby.
Michelle Dutrice?
Yes, she is.
Is she?
Yeah, the man who wrote Michael Jackson's Thriller?
Yes.
He's from the area. Oh, there's loads.
Oh.
I've kept my powder dry on some of it there.
Really? We've got some good ones here. What do you think, Josie?
I think you're doing all right, but you're just not quite there. Bristol is amazing. I love it here, and you'd have a hard competition. Very hard competition.
Listen, the man who wrote Michael Jackson's Thriller is from this area.
But listen, have you ever been nominated the happiest place to live in the UK?
No, but did you win it?
We did. We won it, yeah, back in 2008.
Oh, oh, yeah. She's done me there, Vernon.
She's very good. Even I didn't know that.
Oh, she made that up.
That's really
honestly,
good.
Honestly, I never.
We had a brilliant call earlier on this morning on BBC Radio Bristol from somebody who said, there's one thing that's going to beat BBC Radio Humberside into a cocked hat. Bristol is home to a chap called Dave Prowse. You know who Dave Prowse is?
Oh, he was in Star Wars.
He wasn't just in Star Wars.
He was the Green Cross Code man.
He had two jobs. He did a job share.
He followed Tufty. Used to help people across the road.
But that was just when he was doing his training, because he then went on to become, you know this already, you know this, Burnsy, the most fearsome creature in the entire universe. Darth Vader.
Darth Vader
came from Bristol.
Yeah, and how can you claim? How can Josie claim it's a happy place when Darth Vader comes from Bristol?
Well, I'm happy. We're happy, aren't we?
We're smiling here
because we're winners.
We are content. Now, the great thing about Bristol Rovers, of course, at least they play their games at home in the city that they're named after. Tell us about where Grimsby play.
Cleethorpes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the oldest ground in the conference.
Was there nowhere good enough?
No. It's just we in Grimsby like to spread the joy. So Cleethorpes is like Grimsby's little twin. And it's got a pier and everything like that. And so the two just bump into each other. There is no real distinction.
That might be the problem.
And that's why.
That could be
half
the
trouble. But at least we're not sort of schizophrenic like Bristol, who can't make up their minds, can't just have one football club. No, oh, I don't know whether I like blue and white. I might like red better. See, can't make up your mind. You're indecisive. In Grimsby, it's just black and white.
Well, the real reason is we have so much talent, we need two clubs.
Do you think?
It's as simple as that. Now, Josie's come in today, and I was just wondering, is there anyone who could garner 77.5% of a public vote who you could invite into your BBC Grimsby glamorous studio?
No, you might have us on that one slightly, but we might throw in an actor shortly. We might be live at Blundell Park. We might be talking to somebody who's played for both teams. We might not, because my computer screen's just collapsed.
It sounds great.
Maybe it's powered by a Bristol engine.
Are you regretting going to the Grimsby studio?
Well,
by any chance.
Don't ask.
I have to say, I've on occasions done radio programmes like this one from little sort of satellite studios. And I'm sharing your pain, frankly, Burnsy. I'm sharing your pain. I know what you're going through here.
Yeah, don't worry about it, Burnsy.
Let's go through some of the calls that we've had today. We've had some great ones here. So we had Sam on the text who said, what about London to New York in under 3 hours? Of course, that's because of Concorde. I bet you haven't got a crocodile in your river, have you?
What?
A crocodile in your river.
We've got fish.
Twice a crocodile was spotted. Tell us about the fish, because I can almost smell it from here, Burnsy.
We are Europe's food town, and as I say, the fish finger capital of Great Britain. And I don't know whether you heard this one, but Grimsby, we're really proud of this, Grimsby has the largest concentration of cold storage facilities in Europe.
Are you in one right now? Is there any heating in the Grimsby studio?
No. There's nothing working here, Vernon.
There's some old memos from 1984 pinned on the wall.
There is nothing working here. Can I tell you, let me play you this. This is the origins of Grimsby, just so you know what we're about.
Go on.
Grimsby was founded by a Danish Viking in the 9th century, according to legend. The Viking was called Grim, and Grimsby means Grim's village. In 1086, Grimsby was mentioned in the Domesday Book as having a population of 200. Now the population is around 90,000.
See, we're taking on a giant in Grimsby, really, Vernon, given the size, the relative size, but we feel we're holding our own. I'm going to throw the big guns in a minute, by the way.
Oh, this is like keeping your powder dry. Are you impressed by that, Josie? I'm not sure I am.
Not really, not really. Not what we've got here.
Now, I've got to tell you, Burnsy, here, I do need to have a little blast of me burners. Do you mind if I have a blast of me burners?
Yes, have a blast of your burners. Yeah, go on.
Because we got the balloon fiesta here. Oh, I feel better now.
Well, I had heard there was a lot of hot air in Bristol, Vernon, and I think you're proving it this morning, frankly.
We are very proud. We can do better than just the balloon fiesta. You're not meant to laugh at his jokes.
Sorry.
So you are, Josie, you are.
Josie, you're meant to be on my side.
Sorry, he is quite funny.
Oh, I am quite funny, thank you.
Now,
cheers.
Tom's in Bishopston.
I think that's an own goal, Vernon.
I think he probably is. I'm beginning to regret this. Tom, tell us
Hello.
About the festivals in Bristol.
I beg your pardon, sorry?
Tell us about the festivals in Bristol.
Well, there's absolutely loads of them, pretty much one happening every weekend, particularly throughout the summer. foodie festivals, dance music festivals, festivals that take over pretty much the whole city, and also little quirky ones as well. So we've got one called Make Sunday Special, where they shut off all the roads in the centre of town, and they put like live bands and sofas and hopscotch and all that kind of stuff going on. So it's, yeah, it's really cool.
Have you ever been to a fabulous festival in Grimsby?
No, never been to Grimsby.
Never been to Grimsby. Do you fancy going?
Can I be honest?
You can be brutally honest. Brutally honest.
Yeah, no, I wouldn't mind. I wouldn't mind. I'll go anywhere.
There you go. He'll go anywhere.
There you go.
See, that's a ringing endorsement. He'll go anywhere.
Yeah, best fish and chips in the world. You could maybe bump into TV star and motorcycle racer and truck mechanic Guy Martin in Grimsby. He works in Grimsby.
Didn't he have the best-selling book this Christmas?
Oh, that's what... you're scoring own goals.
No, but no, I think I'm being fair.
No, you're scoring own goals. Or you might bump into Miranda's mum in Grimsby. Or you might.
Yes.
Can I bring in a guest?
What's her name? Yes, bring in a guest.
Patricia Hodge.
Patricia Hodge.
Okay,
right,
and there is a fine acting tradition in Grimsby. As I say, the Elephant Man, John Hurt, went to Grimsby Art College. Here's a young man who was who's a Grimsby lad. He's a Grimsby Town fan. He was in the film, one of the best films ever to come out of Britain. This Is England. Thomas Turgoose is live on BBC Radio Humberside from our Grimsby studio, and indeed BBC Radio Bristol this morning. Our fingers crossed everything's working. Thomas, please tell me you're there. How are you?
Hello.
Morning.
There's a lot of hostility on the show this morning.
Well, we were just trying to pick it up because they're a bit Billy Big Watsits in Bristol.
Yeah,
aren't they? Aren't they? Well, what's good?
They are indeed. I've been studying on my phone thinking, what? A lot of hostility. I think, can't we all just be friends?
Oh, well, okay, if you want peace and love, then let's do it. But Thomas, tell us about Grimsby. What do you like about Grimsby? What would you recommend to those good folk of Bristol about Grimsby?
Well, there's all sorts, really. Like you said, we've got the pier, we've got a nice beach, good nightlife. Then saying that, I have been to Bristol. I was filming down in Bristol and...
with the call of the male cuckoo.
I knew it.
But how confident are you of identifying a female by her call?
What can I say?
Yeah.
We'll just pick up the Oscar now.
Well, that is very good. Throwing in Attenborough. That's
all right, isn't it?
And well, I might have to throw in then. I've already told you about the man who wrote Michael Jackson's Thriller from the area. How about, did you know that there's a miniature version of the Port of Grimsby can be found at Legoland Windsor, including the Dock Tower, the Corporation Bridge and other local landmarks? Can you beat that? Attenborough, but we're throwing in Legoland at Windsor.
The thing is, I know that you are a fan of Only Fools and Horses, and Nelson Mandela House is actually in Bristol. They filmed all the external shots for Only Fools right here in Bristol.
You can see it from Bristol City's ground. Can't you?
And then there's Wallace and Gromit and Shaun the Sheep, of course. And Sherlock was filmed here, actually, just a few months ago.
Did I mention number one singer Ella Henderson is from
Grimsby? You did mention
Grimsby.
That.
Oh, right.
Yeah,
and Elton John. You didn't believe me that Elton John did a song called Grimsby. A load of this, Vernon and Josie.
Yeah,
have a little bit of this. It's awful, by the way, but have a listen. You can sing along if you can remember the words, Vernon. Actually, the man from Black Lace is also from Grimsby, but we didn't want to mention that.
One for us. Takes his time, doesn't he?
Yeah. See, there's Elton. Grimsby will appear. Are you looking forward to Sunday, Vernon, by the way?
Oh, I tell you what, we're looking forward to victory. We are looking forward to this enormously. We've got a special message, by the way, from one of the world's greatest novelists.
Go on, then.
For you. Well, we'll do that in a second. I want to hear him utter the words Grimsby.
I'm just waiting. Did I mention Henry Kissinger as a Grimsby Town fan?
You did, but we didn't mention Bob Hope, apparently. He lived in St George in Bristol. And Dame Nellie Melba.
All right. How about Grimsby actress Julie Peasgood was on the Bird's Eye adverts?
Well, we had John Wesley, and in science, Peter Higgs, Higgs boson, and Colin Pillinger, the space scientist.
Local television was launched in Grimsby with Estuary TV. We beat Bristol.
I have watched that, by the way. It's a... That's a great vote for radio, I always think.
We've had somebody from Estuary TV on the programme today.
What about Robin Cousins? He comes from Bristol.
I think he does mention Grimsby in this song, by the way. I just didn't realise it was so far in. You do realise that neither of us are winning an award for this programme, Bernard?
Not now. No, I gave that up idea loads of times. Now,
throw your bit in.
I tell you, well, if you want to talk music, we've got to be talking about someone who first appeared, made their first radio appearance on BBC Radio Bristol.
My house in Budapest, my hidden treasure chest.
Oh, very good.
Golden grand piano, my beauty focus EOU. Ooh,
yeah, George Ezra, see?
Yeah.
See, we gave him his big break. Has he said Grimsby yet in this song?
Let's have a listen.
No.
Please make it stop. Burnsie, please make it stop. Please.
It's been a real pleasure.
Hey, I've got a message for you.
Oh, go on then.
From one of the best-selling authors in the entire world. Geoffrey Archer's personal message to you, Burnsie.
You are about to play one of the great sides in England. And it's a very great honour for you to be in the final with us. And I look forward to commiserating with you afterwards. Good luck, Bristol Rivers!
Thank you, Lord Archer!
Oh, well, I'm not sure he's a credible witness, but anyway. Vernon, it's lovely to talk to you. Thank you very much
for
your time. We'll call it a score draw and we'll see what happens on Sunday.
You're
pleasure to talk to you. Well done.
Cheers,
to you and everybody down at BBC Radio Bristol. And to you, Josie. Thanks for laughing at my jokes.
Oh,
nobody does
lovely.
Here.
You're lovely.
Nobody does here. Thank you very much. Let's go live to Blundell Park.
There he goes. That's Burnsie on BBC Radio Humberside. And do you think a draw's fair?
No, I think we're the winners, mate. Sorry.
I only said that to be nice, to be absolutely honest with you. Right, the latest news. I want a little chat with you. Can you stick around for a bit longer? I'd love to have a little chat with you now as you've made the effort to come in. And we'll take a look at the latest news headlines and travel in just a mo.
BBC Radio Bristol.
Bristol Rovers are 90 minutes away from an immediate return to the Football League.
The dead ball line cuts it back. Blessing leaves it. Oh, it's a goal! It's Chris Lyne!
After an arduous season, they play Grimsby Town at Wembley Stadium in the Conference playoff final.
His first time cross, it's come to Taylor, and Taylor finishes the game in style.
Join us from midday on Sunday for all the build-up with commentary at 2 o'clock.
Bristol Rovers are going to Wembley. There's a real celebration inside the Memorial Stadium.
Bristol Rovers looking to win promotion at Wembley Stadium, live on BBC Radio Bristol.
Made for fans, by fans. BBC Radio Bristol.
And that is what it's all about. More with Josie in a couple of moments' time. Let's take a look at the latest headline news. At 10.32, it's emerged that Olive Cook, who was well known for selling poppies in Bristol, had been inundated by charities asking for donations. Bristol Rovers today begin their High Court dispute with supermarket Sainsbury's over the redevelopment of the Memorial Stadium in Bristol. And one of the most famous blues singers, B.B. King, has died. He was 89. The weather, a bright morning, sunny spells, fine and dry for the rest of the day. Tops of 17. One of the finest things about the West Country, Aaron with the travel.
Oh, too kind, Vernon. A4 Bath Road eastbound in Salford is very slow towards the Globe roundabout there. The roadwork's just causing a few delays there. Heading into Bath, it's very slow London Road, particularly inbound. Outbound is busy, but inbound is very slow around Margaret's Hill. Also in Bath, A36 Lower Bristol Road is busy towards the Windsor Bridge Road. And just heading out of Bristol, A420 Lawrence Hill is on the slow side. Soundwell Road is busy as well. Motorway's not looking too bad. The M5, M4, M32 all flowing quite nicely. And we've got no delays on public transport. If you do spot anything else, though, give us a call. It's 0345 906 949.
Still to come with Vernon Harwood.
BBC Radio Bristol.
Today we launch our season of programmes marking 100 years since the death of W.G. Grace, and we're looking ahead to what we can hear over the next 6 months on BBC Radio Bristol, telling the story of the cricketer, the family man, and the doctor. So much more to come on that very soon on the programme. Josie Gibson, though, with us in the studio from Big Brother 5 years ago. Can't believe
it.
So you've done lots of things in the intervening years. I mean, you must still get stopped in the street, I should think, from autograph hunters.
Oh, do you know what? I've been so lucky. I'm so, so blessed. And I just thanked all the producers of the show last night, because I went into Elstree Studios last night for Big Brother's bit on the side, and God has opened up so many doors and so many opportunities for me. I just can't thank them enough. It's been amazing. And I'm still enjoying it now.
That's the marvellous thing about it, isn't it? And you've done a bit of presenting as well, haven't you?
Done a bit of presenting. I've launched a new website called Slimmables. I've done fitness DVDs. I've filmed reality TV shows. Oh, it's been brilliant. I've enjoyed every single bit of it.
Is every day different for you?
Yeah. Well,
the variety?
It is a lot of variety. But what I love doing now is just helping people lose weight and get into their fitness goals. That is what a brilliant job I've got. Like, it's, the rewards is amazing.
Because there's nothing of you now. You know that, don't you?
Oh, yeah, I've shrunk a bit, yeah.
So that's the proof of the pudding, isn't it, really?
The proof of the pudding. I did it the right way as well. So that's what I love about it. I did it the right way, eating clean and healthy and training. So yeah, I'm very proud of myself.
And what about the DVD? Is there a new one out, or a recent one out, I think?
So what I've done now is I've filmed various workouts for my website, Slimmables. And you can go on and pick your own workout and tailor make a workout suitable for you.
Yes, I think I might be beyond hope, though. Do you not think?
No, don't
Seriously?
Be silly. No, you're right.
Really? Not being consigned?
Are you actually like a man with a little...
Don't stop there. Stop there. It's enough. Thank you very much.
I'm not saying you've got a big belly, but a little Darby. I love a little Darby.
Stop. Stop.
Little cuddly.
Stop. It's like the people who say, well, about your looks, some women like ugly men. It's like saying that.
It's not, no. Yeah, you need a bit to cuddle, don't you?
Yes, that's enough now. I'm really regretting us asking you in there.
Sorry. But I love chatting about Bristol. I love Bristol.
I know. You were brilliant. You were brilliant with Burnsy, by the way.
Oh,
you
really?
You gave him a run for his money.
Oh, thank you. I just adore Bristol.
We liked him, though, didn't we?
Yeah,
he was alright,
nice.
Wasn't he? Yeah.
The people there are quite nice.
Yeah,
but
it's a shame about the place, really. Well, the thing about that whole Grimsby area on Humberside and the rest of it is that it is alright, but it'll be much better when they finish it.
So cruel.
Nice to see you. Thanks for coming in.
Oh, and you.
Anytime
for having me.
You want to come in, you are more than welcome. You know
oh,
that.
Oh, bless you.
Despite
thanks
the insults.
All right.
I don't mind.
Take care. Thanks for having me.
Thank you. Josie Gibson there.
Bye.
From Big Brother.